Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Diddy Kong Racing playthrough. Last time, we took on the four trophy races of Timbers Island. It was a long, arduous journey through the four trophy races, but we managed to complete all four and earn first place gold trophies in all four, which allowed us to gain access to the true final world of the game, Future Funland. And in the process, we also unlocked a new character, which you see right now. This is Drumstick the Rooster. He is a heavyweight in the same class as Banjo and Crunch. He has the same speed and acceleration as those two, but he has actually decent handling, so this is going to be the character I will be using for this episode, as we are set to begin the final world of the game, Future Funland. Four more courses for us to overcome, and the first race is going to be Space Dust Alley.
Space Dust Alley.
We're starting off with the airplanes, so this ought to be fun. And immediately there's an asteroid floating right in our path. So immediately there's an obstacle that we have to avoid. But honestly, the Future Funland levels aren't all that bad. There are a couple that could be a decent challenge, but for the most part, Future Funland really isn't that much of a step up in terms of difficulty. But I do have to give it points for its theme, you know, having the outer space alien theme of sorts. And I can always appreciate that, being a bit of an astronomy geek and into futuristic stuff. So, yeah, kudos to the theme for Future Funland. Wait till you see some of the other levels that we're going to be going through in Future Funland. So Drumstick here, as I said, he is a heavyweight, and his stats are similar to Banjo and Crunch, but I will take Drumstick over either Banjo or Crunch, especially Crunch, because, like I said, this guy actually has a decent handling stat. So unlike, say, Crunch, I can actually play competently with Drumstick. Whoa! Had a little collision with that meteor. I was expecting it to be a little more forceful than it was. Didn't really come out looking all that bad. Alright, and we're already on the final lap of Space Dust Alley. Watch yourself with this UFO, but if you fly directly in the center of that room, that UFO's shots will never hit you. It never adjusts its course or anything. It always does that strafing run straight down the middle. And there is that safe zone right in the center of the room, so the laser blasts cannot hit you. And there is the first race of Future Funland! I see Taj managed to find his way here. So a quick note about Future Funland. I'm not sure if I really clarified this. Actually, I forgot to do so in the last video. Basically, at the end of the last video, after we won the four trophy races, the lighthouse turned into a rocket and took us up to Future Funland. That's one requirement. There are two requirements for unlocking Future Funland. First, you have to win the first race against Whizpig, and then you have to get gold trophies in the four trophy races. And with that clarification out of the way, let's go to a fun little course called Dark Moon Caverns. Let's go ahead and get started, ladies and gentlemen. The second track of Future Funland is underway with an excellent music track. We've actually heard the music track for this level before during the credits after winning the first Whizpig race. And this is an awesome music track, definitely a standout music track from a soundtrack with many standout music tracks, and this is definitely among the best in the game, the theme for Dark Moon Caverns. What's also awesome about Dark Moon Caverns? This part! We actually have a little roller coaster section here where first it's one loop, and then a sharp left turn into a second loop. I can always appreciate roller coaster type segments in my race courses, because I am a huge roller coaster fanatic in real life. But enough about my personal tastes. Let's focus on this race here. Dark Moon Caverns can be a bit of a challenge at first if you don't have power sliding down, because there are definitely some sharp turns. And keep in mind, I'm navigating this course as a heavyweight who's not going to have the best handling in the first place. But I'm making it. I guarantee you, if I were trying to do this with someone like, say, Crunch, it would be a total disaster. I still remember how rough it was when I actually used Crunch earlier in the playthrough. I actually had to restart a couple of races. I was having such a hard time making Crunch work. Like I said, I can be somewhat competent with Drumstick. It helps that I did put in a little bit of practice before attempting this recording. I mean, look at this section right here, where it's basically a zigzag. You gotta have your power sliding down and being able to navigate those sharp turns to really be able to make it through here. But still, this track has an awesome music theme and a great theme in general. And again, I love the two loop-de-loops at the very end. This is an excellent climax to the track as we end the final lap. Alright then, that is two tracks down, two to go! We are halfway done with Future Funland! And our next track is definitely a doozy! It is Spaceport Alpha! And this one can be a bit of a challenge. This one has a couple sections that can be rather irritating to navigate through. Especially one area in particular, which in many ways, like this part, I hate that part. I always hated that one part right there. But now we get to this part, which is basically an homage to the Death Star run from the original Star Wars. I believe it was the original Star Wars. Basically, you gotta navigate a laser gauntlet, and it is definitely a good idea if you can grab a shield balloon and activate it. It lasts just long enough for you to make it through that area, and I'm sure with careful flying you could make it through without the shield, but I prefer not to take a chance. Now here's the aforementioned hated part. I hate that part so much because you have to suddenly dive, you have to do a sharp dive, and then you have to do a sharp climb back up, or else you're going to hit the wall and lose your momentum, which is extremely annoying to say the least. But other than that, this is a pretty cool track. I think Future Funland is my favorite world of the game based on the theme, and the tracks, especially if you're new to them, can provide a decent level of challenge. So I do think Future Funland is a worthy climax, and, you know, it's worth being the final world of the game. Finally navigate that section for the last time, at least for this video. Because, yes, I'll go ahead and say it, Future Funland does have its own set of silver coin challenges, and we will be having to overcome those later on as well. Come on, I was about to say, let's not screw up at the very end. Sharp turning is still the Achilles heel for Drumstick here. Woo! Alright, we pulled it off. Yeah. And that is it for Spaceport Alpha. Another interesting level, and another level with a very nice music track. And now there's just one level left, at least for this episode. It's time for Star City.
Star City.
I gotta tell you, WizPig's homeworld is quite a colorful place. I mean, the colors of the terrain and whatnot. WizPig lives in a very colorful homeworld because, yes, this is actually WizPig's home turf that we are basically invading. Like, WizPig invaded Timber's Island, and now we're returning the favor by, you know, invading his homeworld, basically. So it's a little bit of, you could call it karma, coming back on WizPig here. He invaded us, we're invading him. And another one of my favorite levels of the game. I love this level almost basically just for the aesthetics. I mean, going through that city, we didn't really get a good look at it because I just blazed through it. But if you really kind of, if you're really able to get a good look at what's going on inside that city, I mean, all those colors, all those lights, all the activity. We have this area with a monorail traveling through it. Now, fun fact, this dome, or this sphere that we're driving through right now, there's actually a lower level to that in the DS version of the game. So if you happen to fall off and land in the lower part of that area, you can get out without having to worry about, you know, turning around or something. And of course, this is another level with some sharp curves that you're going to have to have your drifting skills down, and if you're using a character with, you know, shoddy handling, like, say, Crunch, referencing him again, you might have to do some braking in order to navigate without smacking into the wall. But all in all, this is a fun track. And if you need practice with your drifting skills, this is a good place to do it, if you really want my opinion. All right. And with unlucky 13 bananas, we are gonna finish off Star City. Woo! All right, ladies and gentlemen, those are the courses of Future Funland, at least the first time going through them. As you can see, we have new balloon numbers on the doors because, yes, in Future Funland, once you go through the courses the first time in Adventure, you get to immediately access the Silver Coin Challenges. But if you want to see the Silver Coins of Future Funland, you're going to have to wait until the next episode because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Diddy Kong Racing Playthrough. If you folks enjoyed this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.